live?
Yep.
Good morning, everybody. We're coming to you live, right here from inside the main build facility at Bubba's Exotic Motorsports. I'm Tom. We all know the ladies, man. And there's the master, Bubba. Good morning, Bubba. How you doing today?
Yeah, who put their dick beaters all over the car, dude?
Somebody put their dick beaters all over the car. It's Monday morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a very long weekend. We're very happy to be with you coming off of Saturday's very successful show. This episode is being brought to you by Bubba's Exotic Motorsports.
That's Bubba's Exotic Motorsports.com. You have to stay on the floor. It cuts off at the checker. Jesus. Why are you all the way up there? Back up.
Miss Outlaw Boutique, the most amazing boutique in the world. That's msoutlawboutique.com. 561-660-6695. 1200 Town Center Way, Suite 108. You don't want to miss the amazing things that go on over at Miss Outlaw Boutique. Cars and Coffee of Palm Beach, the Guinness World Record holding Cars and Coffee of Palm Beach, as we bring you 75 years of transportation done Bubba style. TonyRienzi.com, that's TonyRienzi.com, exotic car guru and salesman to the stars, Tony Rienzi. And finally, Monkey in Paradise Vodka, Bub. Monkey in Paradise. Monkey in Paradise reminds you, Bub. What's going on with that?
You need to get back on the floor. You're going to have no ankles and feet when you're talking to the people.
This is the ladies' man right here.
On the screen. You're cut off, like right at your shins.
No, it's not.
I'm telling you.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but how's our audio sound, Mr. Brewster?
Who knows? You don't have headphones on.
You don't have headphones on. What? Is it really?
This guy needs to move to Alaska or something, I swear.
Alaska. I was just talking to my beautiful bride about snow in New York, Bub. So good morning to my beautiful...
I hope there's no snow in New York, dude. I don't even want to hear that. I don't want to hear the word snow right now.
Good morning to my beautiful bride, Robin, up there in New York. Enjoying the weather up there. You're loved and you're missed. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Doin' It Bubba Style. Right here. Right, Bub? 75 years of transportation right here on the set between us with this beautiful Bubba Edition Woody.
Can you start it off with Ford or the year or anything? You just had a dropout Woody right there.
That's up to you. Tell us about this beautiful Woody.
Check it out. So
both of these are Bubba Edition cars.
So this thing, now you're getting really close. So just stay in one spot. This is what you do with Marky Mark. You get real close to a guy. I swear. So this is a 1936 Ford Woody. This thing is really, really cool, man. These cars back then were really nice. This is a flathead V8, right? So really cool. The motor, we talked about this last week with some of the older stuff, they just sound like sewing machines, even though there's full, solid mechanical everything. I mean, the push rods are connected to the camshaft, connected to the rockers, like your hip bone connected to
the hip
to
bone connected to your thigh bones, kind of connected to your knee bone, connected to something.
Every one of yours is broken, by the way.
Every one of mine is broken.
So I'll tell you what, man, this thing is as legit as it gets. So these things, they had different models and different package lines, and every one of them had a different way of distinguishing, like, the front end, the style of it between the headlights. If it had fender headlight or fender lights on them, this one does not, which would be like right here on top of the fenders. There were all kinds of different ways to see what model line these things were based off of. One tail light on the left rear, you know, everything about these cars, they all had something specific back then. So this thing, 1936, moving all the way up to a 2008 Aston Martin, right? So it doesn't get much cooler, much better, and much more aggressive than this little beast right here. These two rides, two totally different animals, but right here at BEM, it's what we do. We cover everything from early 1900s all the way up to today's latest and greatest, even custom order stuff that we're getting in that hasn't even been released to the market yet, some of the 2018, 2019 production stuff that we've already had roll through here for some more BEM design.
But one of the things that's great is your work gets into both of these vehicles right here. Both are back for you to do more work. It's kind of how you do it. One of the things I want to point out to the audience is, especially if Larry Williams is watching out there in Georgia and other people around the world, Gary McCormick out in Glasgow, Scotland, everybody up in New York, everybody around the world, what I want to point out is this is what separates you, Bub, from everybody else in the world. Your technical prowess can pull together this 6-volt system right here from 1936, or you could be working with the 2008 latest in modern technology vehicle, and it doesn't matter. You're so researched, you're so smart, and you're so bright that you can deal with anything on both levels.
It's just a lot of hard work, man. It's, every one of these things, as I've told you before, they all have their specifics. They all have their particulars, their little things that they're known for, their problems, their symptoms, you know, especially like the older model stuff like this 36 Woody behind me. These things are, every one of them has something specific. Like I mentioned, we discussed, earlier last week, I think it was, with older cars, how they all have some sort of parameters or specs that have to be done. I mean, you're talking like specifics with the ignition system, with the fuel system, fuel pump pressure, float level, I mean, everything in your sending unit, your tanks, your oil pressure. Now, you still have all of those same specifics and parameters on today's modern vehicles in terms of electronics, but there's a lot of fail safes, there's a lot of parameters that will go in, and if anything is off, there are other items there that will counteract and self-adjust to make up for whatever difference it may be feeling, not so much on the older ones. So it's a lot of hands-on knowledge and skill when it comes to the older stuff. The newer stuff is a lot of understanding the way the systems work, what makes them go from start to finish, how they function, how they operate, what their end goal is, and then you can understand the modern as well. So it's like a little bit of everything. All in all, it still takes a lot of hard work and just desire to want to know.
It does. And Bub, in today's vehicles, it's a little bit easier because sometimes you can depend on computer-related equipment to give you information to help you figure out what's going on. Mm-hmm. Unlike this, you have to sit down and really have a mechanical skill set and a knowledge base behind you, because if you don't, you aren't able to talk personally to that vehicle and figure out what's ailing it.
Well, I think anything. You know, like you mentioned, yeah, with today's vehicles, yeah, if you've got, if you have a problem with today's vehicles, I mean, everything's connected to some sort of electronic module. It's very, very limited and rare nowadays that you have mechanical part failure and you don't have some sort of kind of a go-to or like a telltale sign of like an indicator, hey, point here, this is what's wrong. Even when you talk about like shocks and struts today's, you know, magnetic suspension systems, they're all electronically controlled. So if there's a problem, typically you're going to get a light on the dash that even says like brake pad failure, your brakes are getting low. That doesn't happen on stuff like this. This is hands on. The only way you're gonna know if your brakes are low is if you're in it.
Yep.
So all kinds of different things going on here, but still the same, to me, the same set of parameters. No matter what I'm working on, it doesn't matter if it's a bike, if it's a truck, military, you know, grade vehicles that we've done, if it's high end exotics, if it's old vintage classic, whatever that span may be that we're doing here at BEM, I feel like it's just all the same stuff. You have to understand what you're trying to do. Like, what are you trying to achieve? If you have a problem, you need to understand not only one, what the problem is, why the problem started, right? And then you need to know if you're doing a repair to it, what needs to be done in order to understand what that part is or that item or component or assembly, what its goal is, so you can properly repair it to do the exact same job again. And not many people do that.
And that's the thing, Bub. You take it from a grassroots fundamental. For example, you were working on Mom's Mercedes last week.
Yeah.
The front right airbag completely failed. It crashed down on top of the fender and rolled the fender.
Yeah.
Okay. And it was a very, very expensive repair.
Mm-hmm.
We just got the car back up on its feet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And one of the things you noted was there were two different systems. There was an active body.
Yeah, ABC, active body control.
Active body control and a non-active body control.
Mm-hmm.
And these are the things you need to know when you go into ordering parts or when you're trying to identify or diagnose properly what the vehicle needs to repair it.
I mean, everything has its specifics, man. That's what I say. You know, we have even just as simple as our guys here, even our admin offices, everyone on the entire team, BEM, you have to step one, start with the basics, man. You have to know what you're working on. Sometimes you're getting a lot of basket case rides, especially the older stuff. Sometimes you're going to get stuff that's completely numbers matching, all original, the way it should be. Makes it a little bit easier when it comes to, you know, ordering parts, finding replacement components, things like that. And we start at step one. Step one here for us at BEM is our work order. Our work order allows you to write down the year, the make, the model, the VIN number, the engine size, the transmission stamp code, the drivetrain that it's got in the car, front wheel drive, all wheel drive, rear wheel drive, all the components and specs that you're going to need to write down. So as everybody is moving through those components, every piece changes. I'm talking from a paint and body standpoint, from a mechanical standpoint, from an upholstery standpoint. All of those items can be affected by that one small spot on our work order not being filled out properly.
That's correct.
So if you write down the wrong number in a VIN, if you write down the wrong engine size, if you write down any small piece, whether you, maybe it's, okay, let's say like base model, let's say Chevrolet Camaro versus a Chevrolet Camaro RSSS versus a Chevrolet Camaro SSSS, 2SS, right? So they have a 1SS, a 2SS, a 1LT, 2LT, 3LT.
There's all kinds
of model lines out there, and every one of those is going to be different. If we have a suspension failure on one of those cars, and that work order is not filled out properly, you may order a set of shocks for just a 2016 Chevrolet Camaro. You get in a set of shocks, but they weren't meant for the dynamic magnetic suspension. So now you've got a totally different part. So that's why it's so important. Then you start with just your absolute basics. of just knowing what you're dealing with, and then you have to take it every step into that, and then it comes out perfect every time.
And that's the difference that sets you apart, Bob. And again, this is just 75 years of just wonderful transportation. Here we have glass belted tires, and they were not good to drive on, Bob, by any stretch of the imagination.
No.
They follow the road contour a lot. They were very, very unsafe. Mm-hmm. Their water displacement was not good. And 75 years later, we have, you know, 500-600 horsepower sitting here on the floor with tread patterns that just on steel belted radials that will allow you to aggressively get through anything.
Yeah, 200 miles an hour is nothing. No problem at all.
That's correct.
And that's in any sort of weather.
By the way, I was just invited by John Zelenga from Cars and Coffee, who is one of our sponsors here, Bub. The Bubba's Exotic Motorsports logo was proudly displayed on the back window area right here of the Aston Martin. I was just invited by John we are going to be at Sebring on the 19th.
Which is next weekend.
And on the 12th, we race at PBIR.
No, it's 2 weekends from now, so we have a lot, dude. We have a really, really, really busy schedule. You know, we've got the Cars and Coffee at Palm Beach. That's coming up on the 27th. That's kind of a priority one for us. However, our best friend is moving, so we're going to be doing that weekend as well. So we're going to be like from the 24th to the 29th is just going to be slam packed. Clark Kent's coming into town, just so you know.
Oh, how you do this. Clark Kent's coming into town. Right on. When is he coming?
Superman's coming, dude.
Superman is coming.
So he'll be here, you know. So we're going to have that going on that weekend
when
along
is he coming?
With. I think it's like the 17th through the 28th, something like that. So we've got the Cars and Coffee event. I know Marky Mark's planning on going to that, even though we should be moving. So we've got to get the move done quicker than that, right? So that's going to be going on Sunday the 27th. We have Hooked on Driving events between now all the way almost every weekend now through then. So just a lot of crazy stuff.
It really is good, Bob.
Yeah.
It's a sobering way to stay active in life. It's a lot of fun to get out there with these cars and to do this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I know one of the things you're talking about is turning in two of the Bubba's Exotic Motorsports Porsches and trying to do something different as well now.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. You know, it's, you know me, I mean, everything in my life, everything's for sale, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
I don't really care with like the whole sentimental value thing. I don't really get attached to stuff because I do so much of it every day. You know, I enjoy what I do. So it's like when I build something, I go out and I have a lot of fun with it. And then I move it in and I go to that next bar, you know, I push it up just another level. And I think that's what I'm looking at doing now with both of the BEM Porsches right now, just going into what's the next level, you know, going up from there. And, you know, we'll just move that bar a little bit higher and just keep playing in a bigger arena, you know.
As we always do, Bub.
Yeah, that's it.
We always do, man. So we're going to jump out of this segment, Bub. It is Monday. There's a lot going on here at the facility, as you know.
Yep.
A lot of great stuff happening here. We can see 75 years of transportation are sitting right here in your throes. And people, for example, this car belongs to John Zelenga, who is the head of the Guinness World Record holding largest Cars and Coffee event in the world.
Yep.
This particular Woody behind you is owned by the gentleman who owns the most formidable collection of Ferraris in the world, mm-hmm. valued at $260 million, and you do all of his cars.
I mean, just to even close on that, I mean, this car, once it's getting picked up, it's getting replaced by a brand new Rolls-Royce Phantom.
Yes.
So this is just another piece of how much further you can swing. So it's not only like the old vintage Ford, Chevrolet, Mopar stuff, it's all the way into the exotics, the lifted trucks, the mud bogging stuff, the drag cars, the track cars, the road course cars. There's custom motorcycles all over in our Woodward Fab and Motorcycle facility right now. I mean, everything to pro touring rides, to resto mods, to classics, to supercars, man. It's all here right now on the lot, and this place is just freaking jamming, dude.
It's going, isn't it?
If I can just get the team to get any work done, I swear.
I'm working like an animal.
Yeah.
I got up yesterday morning. I didn't sleep particularly well the Saturday night and Sunday morning, but I was up at 6 doing all the radio shows and getting things posted and done. So it is a lot of work. But we're working on turning off work, being able to separate work and shutting it off and being able to focus on some of the finer
things. Well, I already do. I mean, I don't even talk to my team after 4. Don't call me. I have a lot of guys out there that can't respect my time. I don't appreciate it. But I shut it off at 4. I do. Doesn't freaking matter. Like, I don't care. I don't care if this place burns. I'll get to it in the morning.
And it's funny, too.
I've got insurance that covers it, and that's it. Straight up.
Exactly. And it's funny, too, because I'm the type of person where I don't hide my personal life very much, okay? I don't mind talking about things. it's no secret, I go see a therapist, right? And that's
why. Yeah, you probably should have started that a long time ago.
It's
no, I don't know if it would have made a difference.
It's no secret that one of the things that I'm trying to do is disengage from work, and I'm doing it with a tremendous amount of success. It's it. It's over. Mm-hmm. 4 o'clock, it's over. My weekends need to belong to my family. Mm-hmm. I need to be focusing on the things that are important, not working all of the time. Mm-hmm. It's like, literally, I was just talking to Mom on the phone, and the one thing she said is, you've got to disengage. People don't need to...
Well, it doesn't matter. You have to look at the reality of situations. There are certain things that maybe a phone call you handle at 7:30, 8 at night, maybe somebody's putting pressure on you, something stupid, maybe something small, maybe big for that person. But at the end of the day, man, 6 months from now, you'll probably never hear from that person again. It will have made zero effect in a positive way on your life. So guess what? I'm shutting it off at 4. You guys can wait till the next day.
Yeah.
That's it. And you know what? It happens anywhere. Try to call the owners of Best Buy. Try to call the owners of Walmart. Not going to happen.
Not going to happen.
Nope.
No, it's not going to happen, is
nope.
it? Well, and it's all part of the progression, the evolution of life. And it's exploring, and it's exciting to detach from the business and focus on the things that are a little bit more important.
There's things a lot more important.
There really is.
These are just cars at the end of the day.
These are just cars at the end of the day.
That's all it is.
So you get it all here at Bubba's Exotic Motorsports, from the therapy to the cars, Bub.
Yeah, probably not so good on the therapy part, though.
I do really good.
I don't know about that.
I do a really good job. Boy. Man. I do a little. Every time I go in to see my therapist, she's got a rope hanging over the rafters. But
yeah, for her, not you.
Right.
She's like 10 minutes with you, and she's climbing up the ladder. She's tying the knot a little bit tighter.
Yeah.
Hanging a little more snug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How about that? Ladies and gentlemen, did you have a question, sir? Everything good? Because I'm getting ready to jump out. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to jump out of this segment. We've enjoyed bringing you 75 years of transportation here at Bubba's Exotic Motorsports. And I've enjoyed letting Bub kind of talk to you technically from that perspective.
I mean, I have three things I'm doing today. Listen, I'm doing one-off exhaust modifications on the Aston Martin. I'm doing factory window regulator repairs here on a 36 Woody. And I'm painting a car this afternoon. So I'm literally all over this place right now. Just three different things I've got going on, which just more of that wide span we do.
Are you painting this afternoon?
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and paint.
Bub, I wanted to share this with everybody before
we left. Wait a minute, where is this?
The Bubba's Exotic Motorsports online store is now up, ladies and gentlemen. We invite you to please go out and shop at bubbasexoticmotorsports.com. This is an example of one of our new phone cases, ladies and gentlemen. This is it right here. This is from the Bubba's Exotic Motorsports Racing Rally Team, and we know that because it says King of the Track, and it has the tire track on it right here. However, there are now regular phone cases with the Bubba's Exotic Motorsports logo. There is clothing out there, Mr. Producer. There are coffee cups. What else is out there?
Jackets.
Tops, everything you can imagine is out there for sale on the Bubba's Exotic Motorsports website right now, Bubba. So we're very proud of you to announce that. We ask you to please go out and support us in this new endeavor, bubbasexoticmotorsports.com. Until tomorrow, Bubba.
Just keep on doing it, Bubba style.
While Bub takes selfies.
No, I'm trying to get my Instagram picture, dude.
While Bub does his Instagram picture, we're going to keep on doing it, Bubba style.
This
episode is brought to you by...
Look at this back here.
Look at that back there.
Oh, my God.
That's what he's looking at.
Look at this.
How about that? Ladies and gentlemen, this episode is brought to you by Bubba's Exotic Motorsports. That's bubbasexoticmotorsports.com. For all the best in boutique apparel, Miss Outlaw Boutique.
Yes.
That's Miss Outlaw Boutique. And you can catch her on Facebook. You can catch her on the web, Miss Outlaw Boutique, at 561-660-6695. Ladies and gentlemen, do yourself a favor. Please go check out that boutique, 1200 Town Center Drive, Suite 108. I know there's been sales going on over there, all kinds of great stuff. Go check it out. Cars and Coffee, the Guinness World Record holding Cars and Coffee of Palm Beach. We're out there the 27th, I think, this month. Come see it. They've asked for the race and rally team to be put together right in the front so you can pull up and see it in person. We will be at Palm Beach International Raceway the 19th, the 12th, and we're going to be at Homestead on the 19th as well. Tony Rienzi, TonyRienzi.com. Exotic car guru and salesman of the car. And Monkey in Paradise, monkeyinparadise.com, the two-time double gold winner coming out of San Francisco. Ladies and gentlemen, please reach out to touch somebody's life in a very positive manner today. If somebody needs the door open, open the door for them. If somebody has holes in the bottom of their shoes, buy them a pair of shoes at Payless. Give them a pair of yours. If somebody's hungry, please feed them. Let's make it a good day out there, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody, Robin, know your love. Matt, know your love. Bub, know your love. Diesel, know your love. There's a lot of love out there, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you help spread it and pass it along. You're good people in your heart. Until tomorrow, let's keep on doing it. Love us all.